ओके राइट, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन पार्ट टू। दिस वन इज द पार्ट वन, इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन। इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन नाइन्थ चैप्टर सेकेंड ईयर। दिस इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर एज वेल एज आईपीई कॉम्पिटिटिव लेवल आल्सो। कॉम्पिटिटिव लेवल आल्सो ईयर main important topics are covered in this lesson. In this lesson, Faraday's laws, magnetic flux, Faraday's law, Lenz's law, and induced EMF in the coil, induced EMF in the coil, self-inductance, mutual inductance. These are the most important for IPE. Eddy current is the most important. Eddy current also most important. Electromagnetic induction, let us start electromagnetic induction. Okay, next, the experiments of Faraday and Henry, those are two experiments, or result are same. Okay, what is the electromagnetic induction? Electromagnetic induction is nothing but the relation between electric and magnetic, the relation between electric and magnetic. The rate of change of magnetic field then produce as a electric field. The rate of change of electric field then produce as a magnetic field. These two fields are depends on each other. The rate of change of electric field is nothing but magnetic field. The magnetic field, electromagnetic, the rate of change of magnetic field is produce electric field, induced electric current will be generating. This is the basic fundamental content. This one is the fundamental content in electromagnetic induction. Electromagnetic induction. Okay, Mitrama, listen carefully. Electric field. Okay, what is that experiment of Faraday and Henry? Okay, Faraday and Henry attempt to observe an induced electric field and conducted long series of experiment. Okay, experiment one. What is that experiment one of? When north pole of bar magnet is pushed towards the coil, next one, pointer in the galvanometer deflects, indicating the presence of electric current in the coil. Okay, when the magnetic magnet is pulled away from the coil, the galvanometer shows a deflection in the opposite direction, that is, which indicate a reversal of the current direction. That is the first experiment. Here, listen carefully. The resultant of Faraday experiment. Here, when this is the coil is there, na? This one is the coil. When the north pole towards the coil, then what's happened? This coil connected to galvanometer. Deflection is there. Deflection in galvanometer. When this bar magnet towards the coil, then what's happened? Deflection in galvanometer means current produced in this coil. Current will be produced in this coil. Next, away from this north pole, away north pole of the bar magnet, away from the coil, then what's happened? Reversible, this reversible deflection is there. If a steady is there, na, this coil connected to galvanometer, steady only, does not relative motion. Here only this is resting position, then what's happened? Does not change magnetic field. This magnetic field does not change. Magnetic field does not change. That's why this is indicator does not deflection in galvanometer. Indicator does not deflection in galvanometer. This is the rest in position. This one is the rest in position. Rest in position of bar magnet. Okay. Then what's happened? Here it does not deflect. Okay, listen carefully. Next one, the galvanometer does not show any deflection when the magnet held stationary. Stationary means rest in position. Okay, when one dramatical experiment is there, na, moving, total moving, when south pole towards the coil, some deflection is there. Away from the coil, some opposite deflection is there. Opposite deflection is there. Okay. Then this is the current produced one time this direction, current produced one time this direction. If you see, okay, do you see this one, this experiment? Here current direction will be changed with respect to time. Current will be changed. Current direction will be changed. This is the basic experiment. Yeah, electromagnetism. Electromagnetism. Okay. Right. Here, yeah, when the south pole of the bar magnet is moved towards the toward or away from the coil, then what's happened? Here, the deflection of the galvanometer are opposite to that observed with the north pole for the similar movements. Total deflection is there. Here a total deflection in galvanometer went towards the coil, away from the coil. This bar magnet moves towards the coil, away from the coil. Okay, right. This is the Faraday's experiment. Okay. Next, experiment two. What is that experiment two? Here, this C1 coil is there, C2 coil is there. C2 coil, this C2 coil connected to battery. C2 coil is connected to battery. Okay, listen carefully. Here, C1 total, C2 is connected to the battery. Then what's happened? C2 work as a bar magnet. Last class I told bar magnet work as a bar magnet. Then here C1 coil, here when this coil towards the this coil, then what's happened? Number of magnetic field lines processing through this coil is decreasing. Then away from increasing, total increasing is there, na? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here number of towards the coil increases, away from the coil decreases. Here towards the coil, then what's happened? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 magnetic field lines processing through this one. Total away from this one, only 1 or 2, 1 or 3 magnetic field lines processing through C1 coil. Then what's happened? The rate of change of magnetic field will be changed. Magnetic field lines will be changed. Magnetic field line lines will be changed with respect to time. With respect to time, here towards, then what's happen? Magnetic field lines will be increases processing through C1 coil. Away from, then what's happen? Decreases processing through magnetic field lines processing through C1 coil. Then what's happen? Current will be generating in C1 coil. That is the experiment. Okay, here then what's happen? What's happening going on? The steady current in the coil C2, steady current coil produce a steady magnetic field. Steady magnetic field means stationary magnetic field will be produced due to C2. Okay, next one. Then what's happening going on? As a C2 is moved towards the coil C1, the galvanometer shows deflection because of magnetic field lines processing through C1 coil will be increases with respect to time, increases. Okay, next one. This indicate that the electric current is induced in coil C1. Electric current will be generating in C1 due to C2. Okay, when C1 is moved away, the galvanometer shows the deflection again, but this time opposite direction. Okay, next, deflection last as long as a coil C2 in motion. Then what's happened? When the coil C2 held fixed, C1 is moved, the same effects are observed. The above two experiments involved relative motion between magnet and coil and between two coils with respectively. Okay, this is the what's happening going on. What is the first experiment? Here, this is the first experiment is there now. This coil connected to galvanometer. Here, bar magnet towards and away from. Towards, then what's happened? Deflection this side. Away from, what's happened? Deflection this side. This is the first experiment. Then this is the C2 coil. This is the C1 coil. This one is the C2 coil. This one is the C2 coil. C2 coil connected to battery. C1 coil is connected to galvanometer. Here, this plus or minus. Okay, right. This coil work as bar magnet, like a bar magnet. Work as bar magnet. Listen carefully. This one is the experiment 2. This one is the experiment 1. This one is the experiment 1. That one is the experiment 2. In experiment one, bar magnet use. Here, bar magnet replacement by bar magnet solenoid connected to battery. That solenoid work as a bar magnet. Toward and away from this coil, then what's happened? Current generating moved away. Then current generating this coil due to induced. Okay, right. This is the first and second experiments. Listen carefully, Mitrama. Next one, experiment 3. What's happening going on experiment 3? Here, this one also, C2 is connected to battery along with the key. Then what's happened? along with the key. If connected this total, key is connected, then what's happened? It work as a bar magnet. It work as a bar magnet. North pole, this one is the north pole, this one is the south pole. Bar magnet, it work as a bar magnet. When key is open, key is closed, then what's happen? It work as a bar magnet. Key is open, then it work as a general coil. It work as general coil, does not produce magnetic field. Then what's happen? Sometime it work as a bar magnet, sometime it work as a general coil. Bar magnet, sometime it work as a bar magnet, then what's happen? Magnetic field will be produced. Sometime it work as a general coil, then what's happen? Magnetic field will be decreases. Listen carefully. Decreases. Sometime it work as a sometime. Means T is equals to at T seconds, T one second, it work as a bar magnet. T is equal to T two second, next second, it work as a general coil. General coil means bar magnet, magnetic field does not produce. Means with respect to time, magnetic field will be changed. One time present, another time absent. Then what's happen? Here induced current will be generate in C1 coil. This one is the third experiment. That one is the third experiment. Okay. All right. Figure shows the two coils. C1, C2 are held stationary. These are stationary, does not moving towards and away from. Here does not moving towards and away from the C1 coil. C2 coil does not vibrating to and fro motion, but it is stationary. But here also current will be produced due to that key. Okay. Right. Next one. C1 is connected to galvanometer. G. C2 is connected to battery through tapping key K. That is the most important idea. Okay. It is observed that galvanometer shows a momentary deflection when the tapping key K is pressed, means K is closed. Then when the key is released, momentary deflection is observed again, but in the opposite direction. That one also same result is there. Your pointer in the galvanometer returns to zero immediately if the key is pressed continuously. There is no deflection in galvanometer. If you press continuously, there is no deflection. Means your magnetic field does not change with respect to time. Present, total magnetic field is present, does not change. Okay. It is also observed the deflection increases dramatically when an iron rod is inserted into the coil along their axis. Okay, right. Next experiment. Conclusion from above this. What is the conclusion? Experiment. Faraday experiment shows that electric current is produced in wire loop only when the magnetic field at the loop is changing. It is nothing but the magnetic field will be changing, induced current will be generating in that coil. That is the total conclusion of from that above experiment. A changing magnetic field produce an electric field. Electric field produced in this way called induced electric field. That electric field is known as a induced electric field. This phenomena is known as a electromagnetic induction. This phenomena is known as a electromagnetic induction. This is the introduction part, the total introduction part. Okay, right. Here, conclusion from above this one, same. Okay, right. This is the electromagnetic field. Electric magnetic flux. This is the most important magnetic flux. What is that magnetic flux? Number of magnetic field lines from unit area passing through unit area. That is the magnetic flux. Magnetic flux is denoted with pi is nothing but the magnetic electric flux. This one is the electric flux. This one is the magnetic flux. Pi B is. Okay. Faraday developed a quantitative theory of induction now called Faraday's law. That is induction. Induction by using Faraday's law. Okay. The law shows how to calculate induced electric field different situations. This is Faraday experiment use for only, okay, right. What is that? How to use this Faraday's law? Why did you where? When did you? When did you? Where did you? Where? Do you use this Faraday's law? This is nothing but calculate induced electric field. Okay, right. Faraday's law use of concept of magnetic flux. That one is the magnetic flux. Magnetic flux is similar to concept of electric flux. Same electric flux. The number of magnetic lines of force passing through an area normally is known as a magnetic flux. Magnetic flux is nothing but number of, what is that? Number of magnetic field lines passing through unit area. This is the unit area. Number of magnetic field lines. Magnetic field lines processing through how many magnetic field lines processing through this unit area? 3. That's why 3 is the magnetic flux processing. 3 is the magnetic flux. Here magnetic flux which one? This is the dot product, scalar physical quantity. This one is the scalar physical quantity. Magnetic flux is the scalar physical quantity. Okay, right. Magnetic flux, how to define that one? Okay, this is the normal line to the area. This one is the normal line. A is the normal line. This is the normal line. This is the magnetic field direction. Magnetic field line. Pi B is equal to B A cos theta. Means pi B is nothing but B dot A. B dot A. Okay, right. If the field makes an angle theta with normal the surface, then magnetic flux pi b is equals to ba cos theta. Ba cos theta. Okay, right. If this normal line area of normal line parallel to this total magnetic flux induction or magnetic field, then what's happened? This is the maximum. This one is the maximum. How to that calculate? This field is perpendicular to surface. surface is perpendicular, but normal line is parallel to this magnetic field. That is most important idea. Here normal is the perpendicular to magnetic field. Normal to the surface. This is the normal to the surface, perpendicular to magnetic field. But surface is the parallel to magnetic field. Surface is the parallel field. If the field is parallel to the surface, that is the pi b is equals to zero. How to say this one? Listen carefully, Mitrama. How to say this one is how to say. Okay. Listen carefully. What is that? Phi b. Phi b is equals to b dot a. If you remove the dot, you have to write cos. Have to write cos. If you remove the cross, you have to write a sign. You have to write a sign. B dot. This is generally here. This is the surface. Mitrama, listen carefully. This is the surface. This one is the normal line. Normal line to the surface. This one is the normal line to the surface. This one is the normal line to the surface. That is the most important. Normal line. If this case, first case, normal line, this normal line produces some theta. Here theta is there, na? This is the magnetic field or magnetic induction. Magnetic induction. Here, listen carefully. What is the angle between normal line to the surface? Normal, this is the second case, normal. This is the normal line. What is the angle between normal line and magnetic induction? Zero. That's why here pi b is equals to b dot or b a cos zero. Cos zero, one. One into something, something means b a. This is the maximum. When normal line parallel to the magnetic induction, but here say perpendicular to the surface. Surface is perpendicular, but here which one is most important? Normal to the surface. Normal to the surface is parallel to B. That's why you have to take a zero. Okay, don't take this one surface. If you take surface, total opposite. But you have to, your theta indicate. What is the theta? Angle between normal to the surface and magnetic induction. Theta between exists between magnetic induction and normal to the surface. Normal to the surface. That is indicate with A. Here, normal line. This is the A is there. Na? Normal line and magnetic induction. What is the angle between this one? 90 degrees. Here, this is the A is there, na? This is the A. Then what's happened? How much that angle between this, how much angle exists between this A and B? 0 degrees. That's why here cos zero. That's why I have to write BA. Here, then what's happened? Pi B is equals to BA. BA cos 90. Cos 90 how much? Cos 90 how much? Zero. Cos 90 zero. Zero into something. Pi B is equals to zero. That is the most important. I hope that all of you understand what I am saying. Okay. Right. Next one. The magnetic flux can be defined for any surface. Okay, right. The total flux is a sum of flux through the individual pieces of surfaces. Total, the unit of magnetic flux, that is most important. A unit of magnetic flux. Unit of magnetic flux is nothing but here Tesla meter square or Weber. Magnetic flux is nothing but B dot A is there, na? B dot A. B means magnetic induction. magnetic induction, this one is the area, this one is the area, okay, that one is the meter square. Area is measured in meter square, this one is the meter square. Weber, Tesla, Tesla is nothing but, listen carefully, Tesla, Tesla is nothing but magnetic induction. Magnetic induction also is known as force by pole strength. Force means Newton by ampere meter. Ampere meter, this is the pole strength. This one is the pole strength, ampere meter. That a unit for pole strength, ampere meter. Newton by ampere meter is Weber. Weber, that is the most important for neat purpose. Neat purpose most important, not GE mains purpose. Weber, one Weber is equals to Newton for ampere meter. Ampere meter, this is the A. A means meter square. Okay, right. Tesla means this one is the Tesla. Tesla. 1 Tesla is equal to Newton by ampere meter. Weber is nothing but a Tesla meter square. That is a CGS units of that one, Maxwell. 1 Weber is equals to 1 Weber is equals to 10 to the power of 8 max. 10 to the power of 8 max. Okay, right. Next one. 1 Weber is equals to 1 Weber is equal to 1 Tesla meter square. Already you know that. Okay, 1 Weber is equals to Tesla meter square. Magnetic flux is a scalar physical quantity. Scalar physical quantity, dimensional formula for magnetic flux. This one is M L2 T T2 A minus 1. Here, listen. What is that scalar physical quantity? Why did you say this scalar? Number of flux, number of magnetic field lines. That's why this only have a magnitude, does not have a direction. Yeah, already this is the vector, this is the scalar. Dot product, A is there, na? A is the vector, A is the vector. Listen carefully. A is the vector. A means what? What is A? Normal to the surface. Normal to the surface. Normal to the surface is the vector. But surface is the scalar. Surface is a scalar. That is most important idea. Here dot product give scalar. Okay, these two vectors, between two vectors dot product is there. This one is the dot product. This is the normal line. This is the vector. This surface is scalar. That the surface is scalar. That is most important, Mitrama. Faraday's law of induction. Faraday's law of induction. What is that Faraday law of induction? Experiment. What is that experiment? Already you know that the rate of change of magnetic flux. The rate of change of magnetic flux then produce as a electromagnetic induction. Faraday's stated experimental observation in the form of called Faraday's law, that is nothing but Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Faraday induced EMF will be generating. Induced EMF will be generating. Magnetic flux, magnitude of induced EMF is the circuit is equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux passing through current, passing through circuit, sorry, coil, circuit. That is nothing but induced EMF E is equals to the rate of change of magnetic flux. The rate of change of magnetic flux minus indicate opposite sign. This minus is nothing but a Lenz law. Lenz this minus sign, about minus sign, which principle can define? Lenz law can define. Here, epsilon, what is that epsilon? Induced EMF, induced EMF or induced electric, induced current. Induced current. Okay. Induced current will be generating in second coil. Okay. That is most important, is equals to the rate of change of magnetic flux. The rate of change of magnetic flux. Okay. Right. Next one, Faraday's law. What is that Faraday's law? How to calculate a potential difference that produce the induced current. What is the induced current? How to already you know that already I told that. Okay. Epsilon is equals to minus d by dt of pi b is there. Now pi b means what is the pi b? Here B dot A or B, magnitude of A, magnitude of B, magnitude of A and cos theta. Here three variables is there na. Here three variables. Then pi B is D pi B by dt how to produce. If B A is constant, this is varying. Which one is the varying? Theta is varying, then you have to do d by dt of cos theta. If varying of which one? Area will be varying. Then what's happen? D pi b is equals to d pi b by dt is equals to b cos theta is constant. Then d by dt of a, that is the, that one also induced EMF. Three cases are there. D pi b by dt is equals to how to write here a cos theta is constant. Theta is constant, a is constant. Constant term. Then if you change magnetic induction, then also produce induced current in that coil. Induced current will be generating in that coil. Three cases are there. This one is the case one. This one is the case 2. This one is the case 3. Okay. In case 3, which physical quantity will be changed? Magnetic induction will be changed. Case 2, area will be changed. Case 1, theta will be changed. Okay. Listen, Mitrama. Listen carefully. Okay, right. Okay. Electromotive force. This induced EMF is nothing but electromotive force. Induced current is nothing but electromotive force. Epsilon is equals to minus d pi b by pi b by dt. Okay, magnetic induced equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux of passing through that circuit. Passing through that circuit. A negative sign produce a negative sign indicates the induced EMF opposes the magnetic flux. That is the most important. That is Lenz law, about Lenz law. Here epsilon EMF by the loop. Okay, voltmeter observed by the voltmeter values. Okay, this is the experiment. A total potential difference produce the current. Out to potential difference EMF produce the change in magnetic flux passing through the current. Already I told that one. Constant flux does not produce induced EMF. Here magnetic flux will be changed with respect to these three terms. With respect to these three terms. Here magnetic, when B along changing, B alone is changing, B alone is changing, then what's happened? Induced EMF will be generating. A alone is changing, also induced EMF. Magnetic flux will be changed. Magnetic flux will be changed. In this case, theta alone is changing. Only theta will be changing. magnetic flux will be changing. Only A will be changing, magnetic flux will be changing. Only B is changing, magnetic flux will be changing. Okay, then what's happened? When the magnetic flux will be changed, then total induced EMF will be generating. Okay, right. That is the most important. Here I induced is equals to E by R. How to write that one? How to write? Here Ohm's law. Did you know that Ohm's law? V is equals to IR. How to derive this equation? V is directly proportional to I. Potential difference between two points. Then what's happened? Two points between two points of the conductor is directly proportional to current passing through that conductor. If you remove the proportional, you have to write proportional constant. That is current. R is nothing but a proportional constant. That is nothing but resistance of the wire. Here I induced is equals to how to calculate E by R. E by R. I is equals to V by R is there na. If you comparison, V is nothing but E. E V is nothing but E. E means induced EMF. Induced EMF, how to generate induced EMF? D by dt, d pi b by dt. Okay, right. Here E is equals to t pi by dt by r. Okay, how to calculate q? Here I is equals to how to write? I is equals to how to write? I is equals to q by t is there, na? Q by T, replacement by Q by T, then here, then induced charge in the loop, induced charge, here dQ is equals to I dt, it is most important, Mitrama, I dt, dQ is equals to, Q is equals to IT, already you know that, Q is equals to, what is that, I is equals to QT from this equation, from this equation, Q is equals to IT, dQ is equals to IDT, here I is constant. Then what's happened? I is induced. Integration on both sides, dQ is equals to I means d pi b by dt by r into dt, dt dt gets cancelled, dQ is equals to d pi b by dr, only r. Okay, that is most important idea. Dq is equals to pi r. Then voltmeter indicate the direction of the induced EMF, induced current and electric field. Summary of Faraday's law. I hope that all of you understand what I'm saying. Here magnitude of EMF proportional to the rate of change of flux, already you know that. Okay, if the rate is constant, then EMF is constant. Rate is constant, EMF is constant. Okay, AC in most of case, this is not possible. AC current result. Lenz law. What is the Lenz law? Conservation of energy. That one is the conservation of energy. Lenz law. Your right hand rule is there, na? If your folding fingers indicate current direction, then thumb indicate magnetic induction direction. That is most important. Okay. Right. Induced EMF. EMF directed along the parameter of flux of the surface. Then induced current is thus perpendicular to magnetic induction. That is important. Okay. Right. Here also, lingula is nothing but opposites of the current. That is the here epsilon. Epsilon is there, na? What is that epsilon? Epsilon is nothing but what is the epsilon here? What is the epsilon? Epsilon is nothing but minus t pi b by dt. What is the epsilon? Epsilon is nothing but induced EMF, electromotive force. Here minus sign indicate lingula, opposites of the current. Induced EMF is the opposites of the current. That is the lingula. States the polarity. Polarity induced EMF such that the tendency to produce a current which opposes the change of magnetic flux is produced in it. That is the lingula. Lingula here. If you coil, if you take a coil, number of turns n is there, na? One coil in one, only one turn is there. E is equals to minus d pi by dt. D pi by dt. If n turns is there, na? N turns, total how many turns? N turns, one turn, two turn, three turn, up to n turn. How to write that one? Epsilon is equals to minus n d pi b by dt. D pi b by dt. That is most important idea. Okay. Right. Induced EMF generating total lingula. Lingula based on the law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy. Experimental lingula. This is the experimental lingula. Direction will be changed here. Direction will be changed. Current direction is upward. Current direction will be downward. Current direction will be downward. That is the lingula. Law of conservation of energy total. Okay. According to downward and upward forces. Experimental lingula. Here also same. Here also same. DB decreases. Here DB increases upward. Upward. Inertial flux is upward, decreases, then decreases, does not appear. Current will be decreases. Induced EMF will be decreases. Okay, that is the most important. Decreases. Experiment 2. Here induced magnetic field will be generating. Current will be Induced current will be maximum. Then what's happened? A current will be decreases in this coil. Magnetic flux will be generating. Magnetic flux produced by induced EMF opposes change in flux. Opposes change in flux. That is most important. Okay. Right, Mitrama, this is Yashoda Krishna from Balnagar. Price Balnagar. Okay, right, next one. Mathematically, lingula negative sign in Faraday's law. That is already I told that one. Okay, law of conservation of energy. That is the total value, conservation of energy. Mechanical power put into bar by the external agent is equal to electrical power delivered in the resistor. Electrical power delivered in the resistor. Mechanical power converted into electrical power. That is the law of conservation of energy total. Okay. Motional electromotive force is nothing but that is the important concept here. Listen. Okay. Here P, what is that? P Q R S, total P Q R S. This total rod with velocity v is there. Okay, PQ is moved towards the left with velocity v, then shown in figure. That is the important Okay, then what's happened? Assume that there is no loss of energy due to friction. Okay, moves toward, then what's happened? What is that mathematical derivation? Okay, listen carefully. Here, this is the total coil, is there na? This is the coil, this rod towards V. This is PQRS. Here, magnetic flux processing through perpendicular to this surface, board surface. Perpendicular to board surface. Then what's happened? Pi B is equals to area into magnetic flux. Already you know that B dot A is there, na? B dot A. Okay. Lx. This is the, which one is the x? This one is the x. This one is the x. This one is the L is there, na? Multiplied area. Then what's happened? That is the total flux, magnetic flux. Epsilon, what is the epsilon? Minus d pi b by dt is there, na? Replacement by this value in this equation, minus d by dt of b l x is there. X is variable, that's why this differentiation on x, then you have to write b l, okay, b l d by dt of x. The rate of change of displacement is known as velocity. Already you know that this is the mechanical, the rate of change of velocity. Okay, b l v, that is the epsilon. That one is the epsilon. This is most important. Thus induced emf in a conductor moving the perpendicular and uniform magnetic field by, this is the induced EMF minus BLV. V means velocity. This rod V velocity is there, na? That is the induced EMF. Okay. That's the way of finding induced EMF. Okay. Right. Next one. Application of eddy current. Eddy current will be generating. Applications. What is the application? Magnetic break. Next one is the dead beat of galvanometer. Next one, induction furnace in factories. This induction furnace will be used in factories. What is that magnetic break? Already you know that in a rail system, this is the magnetic brake. This one is the repulsion, this one is the attraction. Repulsion, then what's happened? That is the move forward direction will be stopped. Total move forward direction will be stopped. That's why train stop with a smooth by using magnetic induction. That is most important. Okay, Mitrama, listen. Next one, eddy current will be generating in that circuit. Eddy current will be generating in that coil or conductor, whatever it's may be. Okay, this is the main galvanometer. Thus opposes is called electromagnetic damping, but ballistic galvanometer reducing damping frames are made of bad conductor like a proper bamboo or paper or bamboo. It is nothing but already you know that old current meters is there, na? Old current meters, one current meters in already you see current meters, one disc is rotating by using electro magnetic induction, electromagnet, this disc rotating. By this disc rotating, then what's happened? Current reading will be increases. Current reading will be increases by using that one, magnetic induction. Okay, by using induction furnace. Induction furnace will be produced heat generating, total heat, total that circuit heat will be generating based on this principle. Resistance of the conductor is very small, current setup in it very strong.